Now, this soul, as in the previous verse we have understood, avinashi putadvirti jena sarvamidam tatam. This is not measurement of the soul, but the power of the soul. You can measure, but not the soul. It is not possible. Soul is so small that it is not possible. We have no measuring means, and because now our material senses, it is not possible. You can simply understand by consciousness, just like when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu fainted in the Jagannath temple, Sarvamo Bhattacharya examined that there was no consciousness. Even the abdomen was not moving. When actually you have consciousness and you breathe, the abdomen moves. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's abdomen was tested by Sarvam Bhattacharya. It was also not moving. So he thought that this sannyasi might have died. But he again tried. He brought a little cotton swab and put before his nostrils. And when he saw the swab, the fibers a little moving, then he became hopeful. So everything has got a different type of calculation, measurement, but so far the soul is concerned, it is said here, apramaya soul. There is no soul for measurement. There is no soul. Therefore, the so-called materialist science, they say there is no soul. No, there is soul. This is the proof, there is soul. This is the proof. What is that proof? First of all, there is consciousness. This is the proof. But you cannot measure. The place is also located. The soul is there in the heart. Ishvara sarvabhutanam riddhesa arjuna tishtati. So, the soul is in the heart and Krishna is also in the heart because they remain both together. So place is also located. You can perceive also by consciousness that there is presentation of soul. But if you want to measure by experiment, that is not possible. Therefore it is called aprameya. Prameya means direct perception. I can see, or I can touch, I can handle. So that is, Krishna says, no, it is not possible. Optimum. Then, how I shall accept? Now, Krishna says, no, how I can believe Krishna? Krishna says, ukta. It is already settled by authority, ukta. This is parampara. Krishna also says it. Krishna does not say that I speak. No. Upta. There is Vedic evidence. Where it is? In the Upanishads, there is. Just like Balagra Satadhagasas Satadhakulpitasas Bhagajiva Savigyaya Sacha Anantaya Kalpita. It is in the Upanishad. Sitasakara Upanishad. This is called Vedic evidence. And another, in the Srimadha Bhagavatam, there is evidence. What is that? Kesagra Satabhagasya Satadha. Sadrisham Jiva Sukshma. Sukshma. Very fine. Jiva Sukshma. Sarupa. I am. Asankhaya. Perfect. This jiva, not 1, 2, 3, 4. You cannot calculate. Asankhaya. So these are evidences in the Vedic literature. So you have to accept it. Krishna confirms it. And actually also you cannot measure. But we get evidence, the presence of the soul, presence of the soul. Still, how you can say there is no soul? No. This is foolishness. The whole world is going on under this foolishness. Not only now, before also, like Charvaka Muni. He was atheist. He did not believe. Lord Buddha also said like that, but he cheated. He knew everything because he is incarnation of God. But he had to cheat the people in that way because they are not intelligent. Why not intelligent? Because they were killers of animals. They lost their intelligence. Kesavadhitasu, buddha sarira, jaya jagadishahari. Those were animal killers. Their brain is dull as stone. They cannot understand it. Therefore, meat eating should be stopped. In order to revive the finer tissues of the brain to understand subtle things, one must give up meat eating.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.